the Fight Numbers Podcast with your host, John Kelly.
There we go. What is going on, everyone? Sorry about that. John Kelly here, back to give a big announcement about basically a new stat that I created regarding MMA DFS. So the stat itself, I didn't create. Fantasy points per minute has been around for a long time in other DFS sports. The reason why this is such a big deal is because UFC doesn't really have any stats other than like significant strikes per minute, takedowns per 15 minutes, knockdowns, submission attempts on average, stuff like that. But in regards to DFS stats, it really is an untapped sport. So how I got this idea was basically listening to the Brett Appley and Head Chopper show on Roto Grinders. They were talking about how Head Chopper mentioned he wanted pace stats. And I'm always thinking, you know, how can I provide more value for people to come to my website? You know, how can I help people become better as DFS players? And what would I want as a player that'll help me and help other people without compromising my edge? And so basically, this is a way to do that. It's not necessarily pace, but it is fantasy points per minute for each UFC fighter in every single weight class. And basically what that's going to do for you is I get so many questions every single week is like, you know, I constantly talk about target fights that score well. And a lot of people ask me, how do you know what fights score well? How can we figure that out? And I never really thought about it, but it's really like, other than, you know, seeing significant strikes landed per minute, you can get an idea of how much of a pace they put on if they generally score well, looking at game logs, stuff like that. But then thinking about it more, I'm like, well, let's see, NBA fantasy points per minute is so huge. That's how you create a baseline projection, is you project how many minutes they're going to play. And if you know how many fantasy points per minute, then you have at least a starting point projection. So basically what I did is created that for the UFC. This is not a stat that's available anywhere, to my knowledge, anywhere else on the market. And I do think eventually down the road, you know, maybe in a year or two, this is going to be something that's referenced very heavily, just as it is in the NBA. We just haven't got there yet because the UFC is a step behind in terms of DFS stats and DFS sport, because it's not quite that popular, right? There's not a lot of people doing MMA content compared to NFL, NBA, and some of the bigger sports. So basically what this, obviously we know outside of a finish, each fighter is going to get 15 minutes to work with. So what this is going to do is tell you on average how many points for DraftKings that those fighters are scoring on average for a fight that goes 15 minutes. So why that's important is because we have a baseline projection outside of a random knockdown, a random knockout, a random submission. You know, outside of any of those high variance outcomes, we have a baseline to project how well these fighters are going to score. So that's sort of the quick version, and now I'm going to show it to you. It is live on my website, fightnumbers.com. It is live right now. I put it up this morning and was messing around with it. But basically, you know, like I said, the UFC doesn't have this stat available, so what I had to do, and it actually took me about 2.5 days. I've been working on it nonstop. So basically what I had to do was go to the UFC stats page, figure out each individual significant strikes landed per minute, divide that by 2, add it to how many takedowns per 15, divided by 15 times 5. So in other words, divided by 3, and that's how many DraftKings points per minute for takedowns they get, and then add that to the significant strikes, which is their significant strikes landed per minute, and divide that by 2. So adding those two together, you have how many DraftKings points they're scoring per minute on average over the course of their UFC career outside of knockdowns, which the UFC doesn't track. It only tracks the knockdowns per 15. It only tracks the leaderboard as of now. So that's something that I'm trying to get down the road. I'll be able to add that. But again, that's a high variance stat, and it really is only going to affect a few of the bigger, heavier hitters, basically. So outside of that and like grappling heavy fighters, because obviously it's not going to have their advances, aren't going to be baked into that. But why that's important is because we already know that grapplers that can't get the takedown or can't get their grappling going aren't going to score well. So now we can see just how well they're going to score it grappling aside if they can't get their grappling going. So hopefully I explained that pretty well. I'm going to pull it up on my website so you guys can see what it looks like. So if you go to the MMA tools, go down to fantasy points per minute, basically this is it. So starting with the heavyweight division, basically I color coded it green, yellow, and red. And all it is green annotates the top third in that division, yellow middle third, and red bottom third. Now, I do want to make it a point to say that that doesn't mean these fighters that are in red can't score well. It doesn't mean they'll never have a 100-point performance, but it means outside of a knockdown or a random first-round knockout, they're probably not going to score very well. Obviously, you see Francis Ngannou down here, 1.12 fantasy points per minute. Obviously, he's one of the best power hitters. He's ending guys in the first round, so when he does that, he's meeting value or exceeding value. But if he goes to decision like he did against Derek Lewis, probably not going to score very well. And that's why, because he's only landing 1.12 fantasy points per minute. Jorgen De Castro, same thing. Derek Lewis falls in that bunch. On the flip side, still sticking with the heavyweight division, Curtis Blaydes tops the division in fantasy points per minute at 4.08. And you'll see, looking at this list, you'll see a lot of wrestlers that rank well, and it's because that takedown is 5 points. So if these guys are averaging more than a takedown per minute, then, or over a point per minute from takedowns, then they're going to score well. So that's why he's up so high, especially if you have guys like Merab Dvalishvili, who lands a bunch of takedowns and he's active with the punches. Those guys are gonna pop pretty well. So basically, like I said, you know, you can go log on, view this. It's live right now. It's broken down by every single division. Like I said, I had to add these guys manually and do the math on every single fighter in every single division. So it was not fun. It was very time consuming, but I think it is valuable and I'm super excited because I think especially, for the more seasoned player, a lot of this stuff, you know, we sort of just know it. Oh, Corey Anderson, we know he lands takedowns and has a decent pace. Oh, go figure, 3.85 fantasy points per minute. But at least now it's all in one place to reference, and for the newer player or one that just recently got into UFC with no other sports around, I think this is going to be a very, very helpful baseline for them to just go look at this and be like, oh, well, I see this guy scores, Ian Kutalaba scores pretty well on a per minute basis. So even if he doesn't get an early knockout, he's probably scoring 70 to 80 points in a win, which is pretty solid compared to other people like Justin Ledet, who usually scores like 65 in a win, and it's because he's only landing 1.75 fantasy points per minute. So like I said, I have every division available. It is up on my website, fightnumbers.com. Let me know what you think. Hopefully that explained it pretty well. Like I said, I'm really excited about this because I think it's going to be valuable for me. I'll be referencing it quite a bit in my breakdowns moving forward, and I think it'll be really helpful for you as the end user, and that's what I'm trying to do is create value for you guys, make my product a better product than anybody else out there, and I believe that this is a big step in doing that. So hopefully you guys think it's useful. Let me know what you think. I'll be back later in the week to drop a strategy breakdown and talk about some of that stuff, but hope you guys like it. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I will, more to come. I mentioned a couple on Twitter. I teased a couple announcements. This was one of them. Like I said, I'm really excited about it, if you can't tell already. And then another big one coming in the next few weeks, and hopefully you guys will be just as excited as I am for that. But thanks for joining, guys. Hope you like it. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I will see you next time.